What's up, YouTube? It's L-E-A-L-E-A-L-E-A-L-E-A-L-E-A. Anyways, yes, I'm wearing the same clothes from the last video. It's because this is the same day. I'm making two different videos, okay? This one is going to be about my favorite seniors. I have to make it's my little TED talk or whatever. And what I'm going to miss about them. I had to make a video, you know. Hold on. Okay. Okay. Yay. Okay. No, ma'am. Okay. Anyways, today I'll be talking about my two favorite seniors. Okay. It's story time on how I met each of them. Okay. I'm going to start with Kim. Ninth grade year, I didn't really talk to Kim that much at the beginning of ninth grade year. Like, at the beginning, it's like, we was quite like, okay, I'm not about to be saying like all 25, 8. Okay, anyway. I didn't really know Kim. It was like that connection where you'd be like, hey, how you doing? And keep moving on. Like, okay, you're my teammate. Wow, I see you every day for 7th hour and then bye. But then it was like, I think it was before. It was like at the end of last year, my freshman year. It was, I forgot what. I'm trying to think. Like, I can't think. We started getting closer as the season went on, though. Like, that's how I got closer with them. I started, like, as the season went on, everybody grew closer to each other. Like, literally, we would all, like, our way of showing each other love, basically, on our team is, like, being mean to each other. And then you be mean back. That's how we love each other. And then we be nice on certain days, but still. So, I think I was playing, I don't know. And we was, I keep saying because I can't freaking remember, okay? I can't just be put on the spot and ask though, okay? Anyways, we got close at the end of my sophomore year. They're like before the summer, at the end of that year. It was the little Christmas party or whatever. Not the Christmas party. I'm finna just say cut and move on. Get your life together. Cause you're messing this up, literally. Okay. Okay, oh here we go. I know who Kim was because she dated my cousin and I seen her on his page, his Instagram. So I knew who she was. But I wasn't, like, close to her. We got close because I was playing with her after one of the practices. And we kept play fighting, I think, that. So then I kept talking to her more and more each day. And then we got closer. But then I forgot. And then sometimes I was like, I know exactly how me and Cam got close. I know exactly how we got close. Okay. So, this is how we all got close for real. So, I would talk to them at practice. I got a little close to them at practice. But then, it was one weekend where Haley and Jada and the Henrys had their little book fairy concert. They was doing a little concert thing. And she invited, and Haley and them invited some of us. So, we was all sitting there. And it was during the fair. I mean, not the Watermelon Festival, which is at the beginning of the year, last year. And it was during summer. And I had asked Cam, like, before that, can she drop me off home? But then they had a little group. Like, it was Lex, Cam, and Ariana. They were going to the Watermelon Festival. And Cam was going to have to, she agreed to drop me off home. But she was going to have to drive all the way across town, then come back to the middle of town just to go to the festival. And I was like, what if I just come? So I was like, Cam, can I come with y'all? So then I called my mom and we just went. So I hung out with them there and we had fun. And she was like, Leah, you want to go back tomorrow or something? So then she came then, and it's like we matched, our energies matched, so that makes sense. I'm just cool like that. But anyways, I know how to match energy, and I'm energy matched, so we just got closer then, basically, at the Watermelon Festival. And then, because Alexis and them were there, too, and they're like, Lee, you should start hanging out with us more. So then one time, I think it was after Watermelon Festival, they had FaceTimed me, both Cam and Lex, because Cam was at Dairy Queen with Lex. And they had FaceTimed me, and they was like, you want to go with us this weekend somewhere? Like, we had went to the movies and to the mall and stuff. And they had me into this group chat on iMessage. Yeah, they had added me into the group. It was like, is this the new group? And all this and that. They're like, sure. And then that's where I got in the Fantastic Four with my friends. Okay. Got in the Fantastic Four. And they added me into the little group. And then it was me, P, Cam, and Lex. We all went to the movies a few weekends after that. And then we got close there. Actually, during them, here's some pictures or videos where I was shy. Like, I didn't know how to dress, no nothing. And this, just look, it's the stuff I put up. Let me scoot over. I'm gonna put it over here. But I was shy. I did not know what to how to talk to them or nothing. So I would always be last. Like, they would be walking in front of me having full conversation. I would just be walking. Like, it was awkward. Like, literally. It was so weird. So I would walk with them everywhere. We went to the movies. I just sat there looking awkward in movies too. And then after that, we spent the night at Lake's house a few weekends after that, after movies. And I just got close to them, like, as it went on, basically, because we all started hanging out more with Fantastic Four and all them. So that's how I got close to Cam and them. And then Lex, I got close to Lex because in sixth grade, we were in junior high, which our school has sixth grade, seventh grade, eighth grade. She was in eighth grade when I was in sixth grade. So I knew her from the basketball team, but, like, I wasn't close to her. So, like, I knew who she was, but we weren't really close like that, okay? I had to put a bonnet on because my hair was looking a little ratchet. And I put a hat on. It's the drill. Stop. Anyway, I knew who she was. So, and I knew who she was by the team. I knew who she was because we played on the same team. And my hairdresser, which I knew from when I was little, her son was dating Lex, basically. But that's the past. Anyways, I knew who she was by who she was dating and what team we were on. And then once I got to ninth grade, it was like, okay, I know who she is. I probably could get close to her as time goes on, basically. So then I got close to her basically during the same time the Watermelon Festival too. So then after that, it was at the beginning. So at the beginning of summer leave of last year, like before our season started this year, I had asked Cam because she dropped me off to one of the practices. But then in that same day, I think it was the same day or like the afternoon before, like the night before, I said, oh, wait, Lee, I got to work, so I don't think I can drop you off. And I had needed a ride. And then Alex was like, Leah, do you still need a ride? And I was like, yeah. So the first practice, Alexis came and picked me up, so I was riding with her. So then she had started giving me rides to, because at that point, I didn't have a driver's license, and I didn't have I had a car, but I didn't have a driver's license. I couldn't just drive, you know? So she would pick me up and drop me off to practice, bring me to practice with her. Not all the time, but. And then we had the little Watermelon Festival thing. I think that was before that, but anywho, you get it. Then I talk a lot with my hands. Anyways, I'm probably gonna be putting pictures over here of all the stuff I'm talking about. But then after that, we had the little, then that's the group chat was made and all that. I already talked about that. But I really, like, Fantastic Four, I really used to be shy with them, like, for real. And all they used to say was, you can't act like that if you with us, Leah. You gotta like open up and stuff. Like you can't, you gotta act like this. I was like, okay, y'all. When I tell y'all, I had a glow up, literally. But anyways. Oh, I also got, my bad. I also got close to them because one of the games, they was like, I think all last year, they was like, out of nowhere, they just, in the morning, okay, Lex, in the morning, she, no, not in the, I cannot talk. I'm sorry if I keep, if I'm pissing y'all off, but I'm pissing myself off. Okay, anyways, it was one of the games last year, and we was doing baseline jumpers, and Lex was like, after I made my shot, that's my son, and then me and Sarah, because I used to, I was close to Sarah. Oh, I still am close, but like I was super close to Sarah. She's like, son. And then the next morning, in the morning, we would go in the locker room. Like, I'm your son. She's like, yeah, I pushed you out. You know, you get what I'm talking about. But like, they started calling me their son. And then Cam at another game, she was like, Leah, you're really my son. So then we started going with that. And me and Sarah would like always be like, okay. So then they started calling me their son. So I'm like their son. I'm not really their son. Come on now. Okay, so, but they started calling me their son. So, like, basically, I'm their son. And then that's how I got closer with them because, basically, I'm not good at explaining stuff. Just shut up, Leah. You get the point. But, I can't really talk about this stuff. Oh my gosh, sentimental. Oh my goodness. Anywho. Then I will go to some football games with them too. I'll go to some football games. Because I didn't have a job. So it was no problem with me going places with them. I didn't have a job. So I would go with them to football games and stuff. I would hang out with them. And you know, as you hang out with people, you start getting closer and closer. And then practices, and you get closer and closer, you know. So, yeah. That's basically all. But here's some of my, and I have invited them to my birthday dinner. My birthday is during the fair, like the whole week. Basically, I celebrate my birthday at the fair. October, yep. And the fair, I was with Kim at the fair. So the fair was like all week. So the Monday I was at the fair with Cam. Tuesday I was at the fair. Did I go to the fair with Cam again? I don't know. But Wednesday I had to get my hair done, so I couldn't go to that fair day. Thursday I went to the fair again. I think I did. I just didn't record it. But here's the days I went to the fair. Anyways, the Friday, I think I went to the fair then too. I don't think we had the whole week, but anywho, we were off, so I did go to the fair that Friday. The Saturday was the 9th, I'm pretty sure it was, and I had my birthday thing, and I had invited Lex, Cam, Ariana, Sadie, Marilyn. I had invited Sarah, but she couldn't come, so Lex, Cam, Sadie, Marilyn, Jada, Haley, Ariana. That's mostly everybody. MK was supposed to come too, but thugs don't go places for real, you know. So I'm just playing. But you know, I had got closer to them there too at the thing because it was like a little arcade thing. So we had fun. And then we went to eat after that, and then we went to the fair. So we had to travel all the way back. And went to the fair again. So, yeah. That's technically what happened. I'm gonna miss them, though. I ain't gonna lie. Who is sad? It is sad. It's like certain days, I be pouring down in tears. And then certain days, it's like, oh my gosh. I just be like, Leah, you're good. But certain, I just be over there. Like, why are they going? But at the same time, they're not gonna be that far. Like, I can travel, but that's still long. They still gone. Like, I don't see them every day. I see them every day, Literally, I see them every day. You can skip 2 days the weekend because I don't see them sometimes, but I still basically see them every day. So imagine them graduating and I'm not seeing them. Yes. And then the team, the basketball team gonna be so born without them. Literally. Like, they literally is the heart of the team, bro. Like, what the freak? And then my voice cracked. They literally the heart of the team. Like, how do you think they the bullies of the team? Like, fun bully, you know. And they literally be making everybody's day. Like, if you mad, they messing with you until you happy again. But, like, literally, they literally the heart of the team. Like, the heart. The whole heart. The whole heart. Literally, the whole heart. I'm not playing. They the whole heart. Like, if they leave, our team will be so boring. Literally. It's literally them two, their best friends, and they're leaving. And we're going to be so pissed. Like, literally. They're graduating. Grown and gone. Probably glad about it. They're gonna be off the charts. Traveling. Grown. Me. Now, we all stuck here with a bored team, literally. We gonna need a new cherry picker. We not gonna have a number 12 no more. We're going to need a new good ball handler. We're not going to have a number 22 no more. Can y'all imagine that? I cannot imagine. That's sad. Then you got to think. If they grow up, go to college, while you're still at high school, and you still have a whole nother year, you got to make sure they don't forget about you. But at the same time, they might say they're not going to forget about you. But sometimes, stuff don't go how you want it. I just got to say it like that. Stuff don't go how you want it. Okay, I don't want to lose my bond with them. Like, all jokes aside, ain't nothing funny. I don't know what's funny, but ain't nothing funny. Cause I ain't laughing. Our bonds, if y'all watching this, Cam, Lex, I'm looking straight at you too. Ain't nothing funny. No lost bonds. No lost bonds. If there's a lost bond, I'm coming up to both of them campuses, and I'm not playing. They gonna know who I am. I'm a high schooler coming to check y'all, literally. No lost bonds, because if it's lost, we gonna find it, searching up and down the road, and I'm not playing. The highway to the interstate, what else? Wrong with them. And this video getting mighty long. Lord have mercy. Y'all, good thing I ain't break down for real up in this video. Tears. Good thing I know how to keep my composure. But when this came off, when I tell y'all, I be in so much tears. I be having you know when y'all laying down in y'all bed and you cry so much your whole pillowcase wet, so you just flip it to the other side. You put the pillow over it so you flip the pillow to the other side of me. Like, hey, oh my God. You flip the whole pillow. Like, girl, it's not that deep. Like, dang, you crying up a storm for what? How you flip the whole like, dang, you might switch pillows. But anyways, this is a video getting a little too long, and I hope y'all enjoyed my TED talk. Stop playing. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. Because I'm going to miss my seniors. Hope y'all like. I want y'all to like, comment, subscribe, turn on post notifications. And comment down below what next I do. I want y'all to comment some pranks. Because I really need some stuff to do. Like, literally. I'm kind of boring sometimes. Vlogs are getting old. Literally. But I love you guys. Literally. I'm gonna miss my seniors. Bye.